Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. It is my pleasure to welcome you here on this 25th annual United Muslim American Parade. I salute him, and on behalf of Muslim Foundation of America and the Board of Trustees of Muslim Foundation of America, I offer him an award, a plaque of respect and understanding to salute him, to appreciate his support for the Muslim Foundation. And I ask Ms. Fatma Shama, the Commissioner of Immigrant Affairs, to receive this award. I also ask my chairman, Brother Dr. Shafi Bezar, and all the trustees, please come stand here so that we be part of this great ceremony.
It's a great honor for us that we have a Ms. Fatma Shama from Mayor Office, who is representing Mayor in the city of New York.
All to know that what we are doing that. In the name of Allah, most gracious and most merciful, Muslim Foundation of America, Inc., and the Muslim community of this great city of New York salutes its Mayor, Honorable Michael Bloomberg, for protecting the freedom of religions and worship for its citizens, as guaranteed under the Constitution of United States of America. Your Honor has stood with steadfastness on this principle. Presented on occasion of 25th Annual Muslim Day Parade in the city of New York on this 26th day of September 2010, signed by Anil Haq, Rector, and Dr. Shafi Bezar, Chairman, Parade Committee.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum salam.
It's quite an honor to be here, and I think that I appreciate, on behalf of the mayor, of Mayor Bloomberg, the recognition that all of you have taken for his steadfastness in the rights and opportunities of all Americans, and specifically Muslim Americans and Muslim New Yorkers during these last couple of months. I actually am proud to be his representative. I'm proud to represent Mayor Bloomberg here this afternoon. I too have something to share with all of you, which is a proclamation from the mayor. I just will read a couple of parts of it, but something to me that really is the essence of what today is representing and what we as Muslims in the city for generations have represented. So when New York's first Muslim immigrants came to our shores, they could not have imagined the size to which their community would grow. And I think this is just a small sampling of who we are in the city. As beautiful as it is, we cover the breadth of nationalities, we cover the breadth of colors, and we color the breadth of who we are and where we live throughout the city. I am proud to join this community in reaffirming the rights Americans have to worship as they choose, and together we look forward to the achievements of future generations of Muslim Americans here in the most open, most diverse, most tolerant, and most free city in the world. So on behalf of Michael R. Bloomberg, Mayor of the City of New York, in recognition of this exciting annual tradition, he proclaims today, Sunday, September 26th, New York City Muslim Parade Day in the City of New York.
Yes. Today we have a Rabbi, we have Reverend, we have Imam here. I would like to invite Reverend N.J. LaRue, please come and take a look this colorful Muslim American gathering, and these people want to listen from you how you feel. It's honor for us, you are here. Reverend N.J. LaRue, please, we welcome you and say something to this audience.
Salaam alaikum. May grace and peace be to you from God, who is the Father and Creator of us all. I have, for the past 33 years, been the director of the Queens Federation of Churches, the Council of Christian Churches in Queens, and have been a strong supporter for religious liberty and for interfaith cooperation. I have always started from the premise that as children of the one God, we are nothing other than sisters and brothers to each other. So I greet you and I stand with you as a brother. We are definitely in trying and difficult days because of the events of the last few months, stirred up largely by political reaction, by those who would proclaim hatred rather than love over the airwaves of this nation, by those who seek to fertilize with bigotry that which was born of ignorance and has been nurtured in fear for many years for newcomers, for immigrants to this land. And you are feeling, unfortunately, the brunt of that at the moment. Do know that there are many of us, indeed I think the vast majority of us, within the Christian community and throughout the nation, that not only affirm the First Amendment protection for religious freedom, but also recognize that it is our God-given and inalienable right to be able to worship and live and work and pray together as one people in this land. It is no mistake that the religion clauses, the free exercise, and the anti-establishment clauses are the very first freedoms declared in the American Bill of Rights. They are important to us because as we are able to engage our God as God would lead us individually and collectively, it is the only way for us to dwell together as brothers and sisters in peace. We support the efforts of the Interfaith Center on Park Place. We support not only the right, but the intent to create an outreach there that would bring people together in peace, rather than, as some of our leaders would do, divide us in argument and dissent. We stand with you. We celebrate with you on this important occasion of your Muslim Day parade. And I appreciate the invitation to be with you again this year and look forward to the future when perhaps the clouds over us will not be so dark, either literally or figuratively in terms of the dispute concerning Ground Zero. God bless you, and may you and all of us dwell together in peace.
Reverend N.J. LaRue, your message was very clear. I'd like to invite Rabbi Michael Weiser. Please join us.
Assalamu alaikum. That was very weak. Assalamu alaikum. I look forward to being among the very first visitors at Park 51 when it opens. Because we all need places, every one of us need places to learn about our sisters and our brothers and the faith and ideas from one another so that we can grow richer and wiser. And I look forward to that day when that building is open and when we can share there our traditions and our love for one another. I began this day about a couple of hours ago by joining with my good brother. I call him my rabbi, Imam Shamsi Ali, who is my lovely and most beautiful friend. And we prayed together, although we were a few feet apart. And I prayed with my brothers and behind me my sisters. And it was such a great humbling honor to be able to share in the worship of my brothers from the one eternal God in a most humbling way. I say to you that the Jewish community, the Christian community, the Muslim community, and other communities in this great city and across this great country are one community. We are all human beings created in the image of God. And we must learn to behave that way, to live that way, to respect and honor one another, and to share our traditions together. And I hope we will see that day come. these words that come from the Bible, Hinema tovu manayim shevel achim gam yachad, how good it is and how wonderful it is when brothers and sisters live together in unity. And I ask this blessing upon all of you, a blessing that is so dear to my tradition and to my Christian friend's tradition, and since it came through the mouth of Moses the prophet, to your tradition as well. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha, may God bless you and keep you. Ya'er Adonai panav lecha, may God cause the light of the divine presence to shine on you and grace you. Yisa Adonai panav lecha v'yasem lecha shalom, and may God lift the divine presence up to you, grant you always the blessing of inner peace, now and always. Amen. Ken Yehi Ratzon, may this be God's desire. Assalamu alaikum.
What was a street? What a young guy, Michael Weiser. Thank you, you know, you woke us up.
Thank you, Imam Michael Weiser. And thank you, Imam Angel Roof, for this opportunity. Brothers and sisters, in Islam, there are four levels of brotherhood. There is al-uhuwa al-usariya, there is a brotherhood within the family, and we thank Allah for that opportunity. The second level is al-usra al-wataniya al-sha'biya, that is a brotherhood within ethnic backgrounds. And alhamdulillah, there are many, many different brothers around here that present today. The next level of brotherhood is al-uhuwa al-islamiya al-imaniya, and that is brotherhood within the faith. But don't forget that above all these, there is the most universal brotherhood in al-Islam, and that's what Allah says in the Holy Quran. Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu. O mankind, we created you from a single man and a female, and we make you into nations and tribes so that you may get to know one another. The Rabbi who is here, we claim he is our brother. The Reverend who is here today, we claim that he is our brother in humanity. So no matter what religion you follow, we are all brothers and sisters. And that's why, out of fairness, let me thank many for today's event. Number one, all New Yorkers and all Americans who have stood to our side in support of the constitution of this country and in support of the right of Muslims to worship Allah and God in this country and anywhere else. And in particular, we would like to convey our high appreciation to the Mayor Bloomberg, who I was there standing to his side when he strongly supporting the Muslim community to pursue their religious right, alhamdulillah. So thank Mr. Mayor Bloomberg for that opportunity. Now let me, out of fairness, address the Muslim community here today. Injustice, and to speak against evilness, even if this occurs within our own Muslim community. If it is not us to clean our house, who else to clean our house, my brothers and sisters? Inshallah, Dr. Nihad is going to talk on the other side. But let me just talk on the other side. We need to remind ourselves constantly that we must clean our house before anyone else come and clean our house. That is our responsibility, my brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah, Imam.